because you get like the lookalike thing. Obviously, this face, fucking hilarious. But I was doing a gig in Barnsley the other week, and I like came on stage, and before I even had a chance to say anything, a guy really near the front just went,
"Yeah, he is.
Are you the guy from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids?"
Okay.
It's a really good way to start. Guys, we're going to get another fantastic act for you, and we're going to get Steve Rimmer. But first, let's just check. Right, we've just got to make sure, I've realised I should have done this at the start. The rules are, don't talk while the act's wrong, you've done well so far, and turn your mobile phones off. I forgot to say that, I'm a terrible person. But ladies and gentlemen, we need to get you riled up. Team Awesome, give me a cheer! Team Fantastic, give me a cheer! Now ladies and gentlemen, please start stamping your feet! Oh! No, no, you fucked it up! Start stamping those feet! Start clapping your hands! Start whooping and cheering! Are we all doing alright?
Yeah.
Having fun?
Yeah.
I'll move out over there because Jed kept walking behind it and I couldn't see him for a bit of it. My name's Steve Rimmer and I like pubs, going to the cinema, I like socialising with friends, I like nights in, and I also like nights out. And I know that you think that sounds a little bit like a dating website profile, don't you? But it is, it's mine. And to be honest, the reason I'm telling you this is because you lot will listen. Unlike those shallow women at home on the internet that just say, look at this, go fuck that next. You know what I mean? But I am on that website, and I'm after a girlfriend. And the type of woman I want, she's got all the kid, because I've got a little boy. And we can do things together on a weekend. But you have to be careful, because you know there's them women out there that are spinsters that get photographs with the nephews and nieces. So, you know, you have to ask them the right questions and I write in the message. I say, hi, my name's Steve. Nice profile picture of you and your kid. I like kids. Have you got any more pictures of your kids? But, just don't get back to me, to be honest. I'm on that website, but I don't really know why I am, to be honest, because I was in love once and you do some crazy things when you're in love, don't you? Stuff you would never normally do. Like, I knew that my girlfriend was cheating on me. And I never confronted her with her because I loved her and I didn't want her to break up with me. And then the thing is, I actually found out she was cheating on me because I went down on her once and I could taste condoms. Yeah, I know, sick in it. I know you're thinking, how do you know what condoms taste like? But you heard that saying, haven't you? What would you do for £1 million? But this guy said to me, he said, would you suck a dick for £1 million? I said, yeah, of course I will, but I'm going to put a condom on it, I'm not gay, do you know what I mean? Anyways, by the end of it, the joke was on him because it turned out he'd never even had £1 million, so there was a reason there. Fair enough. But yeah, eventually we did break up, you know, because what happened was I went in the bedroom and she caught me catching her cheating on me, you see. I walked in the room and we had eye contact with her, had eye contact with him, had eye contact with the other guy. I mean, like, we all had eye contact, you know what I mean? And, you know, I ended up breaking up with her. And it really broke my heart. And you know, the worst thing about that is, you know, having a heart broken. It's not the worst thing. The worst thing is I can't watch free internet porn anymore. Just in case one day I stumble across some footage of me in the background just crying, trying to sneak out of a room. It's not good, it's not good. So we're halfway through the year. How's anybody still keeping up the New Year's resolutions? Anyone? No? Just me then. One of them was going to go stand-up comedy, so I'm like 7 months into it now. Another one is that free running, do a bit of free running. I say free running, not like the jumping on the wall shit, I mean I've freed running for my life. Which is brilliant. Just have a rest all the time, it's really, really good. We miss a lot of buses though. Another thing that happened to me this year is I turned 32. And you know, I want 32 to be a really good, cool year, do you know what I mean? But to be fair, the only way 3 and 2 is ever going to look good is with double D on the end of it, do you know what I mean? There's a little boob joke there for the lads. I love boobs, I've even grown my own. Yeah, that's what free running from your life does to you. Do you know what I mean? Another thing that happened to me, you know, I wanted to have a midlife crisis a little bit early on. I couldn't afford a sports car or a motorbike, so I did the next best thing. And I got myself one of those remote control aeroplanes. You know, it cost me £350, took me 3 hours to build, and 30 seconds to crash. It's a true story. But it's not a total loss, because I videoed it. I've actually got it on my iPad at the minute. I would have said it to you, been framed. And there's the thing, Jerry Regal was alive and loved the iPad, wouldn't he? But Leo Randy probably prefer the iPhone. There's another thing about the iPhone. Anyone that owns an iPhone, you'll attest to this, won't you? I know where, by the way. I know some fit chicks, you know what I mean? Not there, I just know some fit chicks. But yeah, the thing about the iPhone is, anyone that's got one always refer to it as an iPhone, don't they? They never say, oh, have you seen my mobile? It's, have you seen my iPhone? Do you want to use my iPhone? It's not like my ex-girlfriend. She never used to say, have you seen my Nokia 5310? I'm not saying she had a shit phone, I'm just saying that's how long ago it was since I had a girlfriend. Which is why I'm on that website anyways. You know what I mean? I have always been a bit of a comrade, to be honest. I was always the first man, boy, at the front of the airstream back queue. I'd look up at the man and say, I'll have a 69er, please.
Yeah,
take that, he was on the register. Yeah, you got that. Back then, I've squirted sauce on the airstream to this day because of it. Sick. I'm only kidding, there weren't a lot of paedophiles around when I was growing up, you know, we had to buy our own sweets. And if you wanted to see some puppies, you had to go to the local pet shop. Imagine if there was an old man there, and if he was young enough, he'd let you whack him off. I'm kidding, there weren't a lot of paedophiles around. Are we all drinking tonight, you having a bit of fun? Drinking beer?
Yes!
Nobody's drinking milk. Do you know why? It's going out of fashion. Them adverts used to be on, it looked brilliant, they're not on anymore. And I love milk, and not a lot of people are drinking it, so I'm going to try and advertise. And if I was to discover milk, you know, back in the day, a human being discovered that he could drink animal's milk. But if that was to happen today, you would take that into the dragon's den, wouldn't you? You'd be up there in front of the dragons with your milk. You'd be like that, look, milk. Duncan's not interested, is he? Because to be fair, he runs health sweets. He'd be like, I believe water is the only thing you should put in your body. For that reason, and that reason alone, I hope. Theo, he's not interested, because let's be honest, he's probably drinking Mrs. P's milk. But Deborah, she's well keen. She wants to know how you've come across this discovery, because to be fair, the only thing that comes out of her tits is dust, in it? So, I mean, so you would have to explain it, wouldn't you? You'd have to say, well, I was walking through a field one day, and I tripped and fell, and my head hit this cow's butt, and I was shocked, and my mouth opened, and a bit went in. At least that's how I'd explain it, do you know what I mean? And that's got to make you think, what was the first person doing that very first tasted a chicken's egg? Because, you know, for all intents and purposes, he's just watched a chicken have a shit and thought, oh, I'm going to eat that. So, that's not good, is it? Now, I've been in stand-up comedy for like 6 months now, and it's not my main job, obviously. I've got a main job, and believe it or not, I'm actually a bomb disposal engineer. It's quite impressive, isn't it? Yeah, and it's not just something, thank you very much. I should be difficult with me, all the time. It's not just something that I used to put in my set, like people say, just for jokes. I really am a bomb disposal engineer, and I travel the country looking for World War II bombs. And then people say to me, all right, well, is it the red wire or the green wire? I say, I don't fucking know, I'm not an electrician, you know what I mean? But, I got into that job, actually, by being in the army. And the reason why I joined the army, actually, is when I was younger, my granddad sacked me from that pet shop, and there was no way I was going to work with my uncle on that ice cream van, I'm telling you. So, there's another thing about when you meet someone that was in the army, they can't wait to tell you, can they? It's taken like 3 minutes and they have been holding back, to be honest. I wanted to run up there and just go, hey, I'm in the army. But I'm like, you won't believe it. But so I'm a bomb disposal engineer, and when I was in the army, with the Royal Engineers, we'd go up tall and I'd wear this t-shirt saying, I'm a bomb disposal engineer, and if you see me running, keep up. So I'm going to wear a similar t-shirt now, and I'm doing my very first proper comedy gig in Hull, and if you see me run it, it went shit. How are we doing tonight? We having fun? Good? We're all still drinking? Good. I am actually drinking booze, like, we're all proper bloke. But I've got a beer over there, so I've got to rush off, because there's a problem with leaving drinks around in bars, isn't there? And let's be honest, it's date rape, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? To be fair, I'm a target, do you know what I mean? But, you'll be wasting your time, ladies, because I'm actually immune to it. Seriously, I went clubbing the other week, right? I took loads of work hitting up, and nobody fucked me. And anyways, bro, I look like the type of guy that'll say no to sex. I will shag anyone, right? Great, how you doing? Do you mind? I'll shag you as well. Okay, try it out. I will shag anyone, right? I was with this woman the other week, right? She was so big. I couldn't actually kiss her while I was inside of her. I had to come out, walk around the bed, You don't like it? So I'm just going to go for some more sets. I'm back in a minute, aren't you? But to be fair, I did use a front flavoured condom. Then we're going to get one of the father dates in a minute. By the way, not too bad that joke, wasn't it? I did actually do that joke on a gig in London, right, the other week, and there was a big woman sat in the audience, and I said to her, I didn't offend you, dear love, it's just jokes, and if I did, I'll buy you a drink and some chips. And I said to her, I'll tell you what, if you buy me 7 drinks, I'll probably fuck you. And she did, and I did.